Hello and welcome a new tutorial. I will try to show you how to make a full functional tank animation this time. This is my simple tank model which I'm using in my channel's intro. Simple or not, all models work with same principles. Just try your models. I prepared the dynamics before, to keep this video as short as possible. If you want to know how I did this, please go and watch my fast and easy tank tracks tutorial. We need to give some thrust and add some steering to the mini tank. To do this, we will use the user data and Expresso editor. We will use these four motor objects to make various movements. The thrust value must be in degrees. Motors need degrees. The numbers you see here are flexible. Try yours. We will give negative and positive values to make motors move forward and reverse. Do the same adjustments for steering. It's not a must to use same numbers. This is suitable for this animation. Our tank is not big enough, these values are good for it. User data sliders are ready to go. But Expresso is a must for this. First, drag these four motors into the editor. We use the angular velocities, the torque should a little bit higher if you use some obstacles to climb in your scene. For now, just give some thrust to motors and test them. We expect forward and backward movements. Yes, it works. But there seems to be an imbalance problem. The center of mass is incorrect. To correct the balance, select all connectors and the dynamic tag of body object. You see, the intersection point of yellow lines are some high. Just customize this. Since the front part of the vehicle is heavier, we need to move this point lower and slightly back. It looks good. But these connections are not right. Remember the steering. Tank's steering is different from other vehicles. Increase or decrease left and right motor thrusts, make the tank rotate to a direction. We will multiply the steering value by positive 1, and negative 1, for forward and reverse movements. Then, add them to the actual thrust value. Positive values for right motors, and negative ones for left motors. These values will vary among themselves, depending on the situation. Even if the tank is not moving, steering values will move it. Did you see the reverse movements? We have not added some thrust to motors yet. Now, we do this. The thrust and the steering values are mixing nicely. We never think which one is negative or positive anymore. It knows what to do. We have a turret, and other parts are child of it. We should rotate the turret in H-axis 180 degrees to negative and positive directions. And the barrel should move down or up, on P-axis. Please, do the same adjustments you see in User Data Manager. In Expresso Editor, just connect them to the right ports. Watch this. As you can see, they work as they should. Are we ready for some cannon shooting? You see a bullet in the barrel. It moves with turret and barrel. The barrel should be a static mesh, to prevent the bounding box issues. Make the bouncing and friction values low. The bullet has two tags. First, adjust the rigid body values as seen. We will need the Enable Dynamics checkbox, and Linear Velocity on X direction. After this, the bullet's mass should be higher for damage the targets well. In User Data Manager, we need a value for shooting power. I call it as powder. Give any values you wish. nothing will work without a trigger. The trigger will have two values, 0 and 1. In other words, load and fire. Do not forget put semicolons after the numbers. Put the dynamic DAG into the Expresso editor. We will first enable it, and then give some power. Now, for the bullet, we either show or hide it depend on the trigger. Let's make the visibility box checked. If the trigger is 0, we will hide it. If we pull the trigger, it becomes visible. 1 is the real value. It equals to 100%. Alright. The bullet is coming soon. Even if we fire more than one shot, we actually use a single bullet. If you reload before the bullet reaches the target, it will suddenly disappear. Wait until the target is hit, then fire the second round. Thank you for taking the time to watch me. See you next time.